engineered landfills are very different from small dumps you may have seen in the past or in pictures. From construction to closing the landfill, from daily operations to a new use after the landfill, planning and good management is key. This video provides an overview of what a modern landfill is and how it operates, using the Walker Environmental South landfill as an example. Walker Environmental has built and operated landfills for over 30 years. Landfills are constructed in sections called cells. Each cell's liner system is built, and all facets of that cell are connected to the neighboring cell liner. Once all cells have been constructed, a virtual bathtub has been created with one continuous liner being in place on all sides and floor of the landfill. The liner is about 12 feet thick and mainly collects precipitation water that has been in contact with the waste. This contact water is called leachate. There is a primary liner system and a secondary liner system that, when combined, create a landfill that meets the requirements of the Ontario Ministry of the Environment and Climate Change and is considered to be fully protective of the environment. What happens when the waste arrives at the landfill? Walker Environmental landfills accept solid, non-hazardous waste only. Waste materials must be pre-approved before the materials are shipped to the landfill. Trucks are turned away if the waste is not pre-approved. At the scale house, the truck is weighed and the scale house clerk confirms pre-approval from database records. The truck is then directed to the daily working area within the landfill, and our compactor operator employees inspect the waste as it comes out of the truck. If any material is unsuitable, it is immediately reloaded back in the truck and taken away. Each day, only a small portion of the landfill is used, as planned out by the team ahead of time. Working in a small area minimizes the potential for impacts like odors, blowing materials, and birds. At the end of each day, daily cover material is placed on top of the waste. Daily cover is usually soil. Daily cover isn't the only thing we use to minimize the potential for negative impacts like odors, birds, and blowing materials. We have fences that trap the litter and employees who pick it up if it blows over the fence. There are two people on our team in Niagara whose full-time job is wildlife control. Their main goal is to prevent seagulls from visiting the site. Birds of prey like peregrine falcons and owls have been trained by our falconer to fly around the landfill and keep the seagulls away. There are a series of pipes that collect landfill gas from inside the landfill. This minimizes the potential for odor, and the gas can be used as a renewable energy source. Landfills hire third-party experts who monitor the environment throughout the year to confirm that there are no impacts to either ground or surface waters. This information is contained in each year's annual report, which is submitted to the Ontario Ministry of the Environment and Climate Change, the MOECC for short. A lot of planning goes into closing a landfill to protect the environment and to map out how the landfill will be maintained into the future. The landfill is covered with a thick cap of clay, which limits the amount of rainwater that infiltrates into the waste. The clay cap is then covered with a layer of topsoil and seeded to prevent erosion. When a landfill is closed, our responsibilities do not end. We continue to monitor groundwater and surface water. We also continue to submit annual reports to the MOECC. Also, leachate, or water that has come into contact with the waste, continues to be collected and treated. Over time, the quality of leachate water improves. Once the water quality meets standards established by the MOECC, the treatment requirements change. In addition, landfill gas continues to be collected and managed after the landfill closes. Over time, less and less gas will be created until it doesn't need to be managed anymore. Once a landfill is properly closed, it can become something new again. You may have enjoyed a closed landfill as a dog park, hiking trail, or golf course, to name a few. At Walker, we partnered with the University of Guelph to show that a landfill can be returned to agricultural use. These agricultural uses include crops that can be used in the compost manufacture process, used as a biofuel supplement, or used as a livestock feed supplement. At Walker, we view landfills as a temporary use. using industrial land for a second purpose before turning into something new again. Hopefully this video provided you with some helpful information about how landfills are built, operated, and closed. Also, how the land can be used again. For more information about landfills and Walker Environmental, visit our website at www.walkerind.com.